So last week I talked about how restarting your Mac can help fix some problems. But there's something even more that you can do. In addition to restarting your Mac, you can also clear out a little portion of memory that persists between restarts. It actually saves some settings and it's not cleared out when you restart. It's called Nvram. And Nvram stands for non-volatile RAM. RAM is memory. In the old days it used to be called PRAM or parameter RAM. It's basically the same thing, but the keyboard shortcut for doing this still uses the key P and R in addition to Option and Command to clear this out. So what you need to do is you need to restart your Mac, and as soon as you restart, hold down Option, Command, P, and R. And then it will go through the restart once, and as soon as it finishes that and goes through it again, then you can lift your fingers up off the keyboard and let it start normally. And this clears out this little bit of memory that holds various things. According to the Apple document here, it can hold various bits of information about like startup deselection, time zone, things like that. Clearing it out can sometimes just get rid of certain issues. It really depends on what the issue you had was, what went wrong, like an app crashed or something like that, what extensions and different things you have installed on your Mac. But it is something that's worth trying if you have a problem that persists. Like for instance, for me, I recently had a problem on my new 13-inch MacBook Pro with the Touch Bar where it stopped asking me for the Touch ID to log in. I had to type my password instead of using Touch ID. And it turned out that the only thing that fixed it was clearing out Nvram by holding those keys down during a restart. And then it went back to normal. So that's an example of a problem that you might fix. If you're not having any problems, there's no reason to ever do this. So it's the kind of thing you may go through the entire life of your Mac and never do it once. But if you're using beta software, development software, things like that, it may be the kind of thing where you need to do it quite often.